Hey Philharmonic kids, hello from Ottawa, Canada.
Ottawa is the capital city of Canada, and so this is where the government is. This is Parliament.
Parliament has two houses, just like the United States Congress.
The last time I was in Ottawa, this part was all blocked off, and there were a lot of protesters.
They were demonstrating against environmental pollution and advocating Native American rights.
Canada's Indigenous people make up about 4% of its population, and their issues are similar to the ones you've been studying in your Native American studies. Ottawa is built on the Ottawa River and has this wonderful system of canals. In winter, the canals freeze over and the ice is thick enough that people can skate on it. They even skate to work or to school. This is a park in Ottawa, just across from Parliament Hill. It's fewer people than Central Park, but they still like to play soccer. Canada and the United States have been allies in world wars and global conflicts. This monument commemorates Canadians who fought in these wars. On the other side of the park, there are statues and plaques commemorating animals who fought in the wars. Canada is a bilingual country. Just about everything is labeled in English as well as in French.
This is the National Arts Centre where I'll be working. It's a lot like Lincoln Center. They have music, dance, theater, and more! This is a canal just down the hill from the National Arts Centre. The ceiling is concrete, so there's a really cool echo.
The National Arts Centre Orchestra is one of the world's greatest orchestras. They sound amazing, just like the New York Philharmonic.
Here's a map of the Arts Centre. The architect really liked hexagons.
How many hexagons can you count in this picture? And what about on this doorknob?
Good grief! More hexagons!
But not everything in Ottawa is a hexagon. In fact, you may even see an occasional octagon.
Guess what? Another hexagon. This is the stage door. This is where the musicians and the conductor and the ballerinas and all the professionals enter.
This is the inside of the National Arts Centre. Over there is where you buy tickets.
This whole room is a hexagon.
But do you want to know my favorite thing about Ottawa? More hexagons! No, hexagons are not my favorite thing about Ottawa.
Bacon!
No, Canadian bacon's great, but it's not my favorite thing about Ottawa.
My favorite thing about Ottawa is this life-size statue of Canadian jazz legend Oscar Peterson.
Oscar Peterson was one of the greatest jazz musicians of all time.
In fact, Duke Ellington called Oscar Peterson the Maharaja of the keyboard, which means he's really good. You can hear this sculpture actually plays music. Well, the sculpture is not actually playing music, but there are some speakers up there. And that's Oscar Peterson's playing. And you can see in the center of a keyboard, it has the brand of the piano. This one is Burzendorfer. It's one of my favorite kinds of piano. It sounds really good, and they're really expensive. There's a little spider dancing around on a plaque. I think it likes jazz as much as I do. And there's a biography of Oscar Peterson.
Oscar Peterson had a famous ensemble called the Oscar Peterson Trio. I got a less famous ensemble called the Doc Wallace Trio. So what am I doing here at the National Arts Centre of Canada? Well, I'm here because their orchestra does a lot of community concerts, kind of like the ones that the New York Philharmonic teaching artists have done at PS 165 and other schools in New York City. And so I'm here to help them do the best job they can with their in-school concerts and with their concerts in community. And guess where they're going? They're going to China. That's right.
that's one of the best things about being a musician, is you get to travel to wonderful places like Ottawa.
And that's the honest truth, ladies and gentlemen.
Manhattan's Coffee Company? I thought I was in Ottawa, not Manhattan.
Bacon! Bacon! Bacon!